What's up? It's Jessica and welcome to CritIC, the Tox Series. Toxidromes are a collection of symptoms frequently seen in poison patients. Recognize the toxidrome and you'll have a better understanding of what the patient has taken, how to treat it, and to anticipate for problems to come. This video covers the opioid toxidrome. Let's go! With the emerging opioid crisis in the US, recognizing the opioid toxidrome is extremely important. In the opioid toxidrome, all vitals are downregulated and respiratory depression is common. It has a lot of similarities with the sedative hypnotic toxidrome discussed next, and there is a really effective antidote available. So let's go through it. When assessing the patient with the opioid toxidrome, this is what you'll typically see. In A, if your patient has a reduced level of consciousness, then the airway is threatened. Apply the triple airway maneuver. If your patient breathes insufficiently, start bagging. In B, severe bradypnea. If severe enough, oxygen saturation will start to fall. Lung sounds are usually normal, but severe opiate overdose is associated with pulmonary edema. Beware that these patients have an increased risk for aspiration due to their reduced level of consciousness. Monitor respiration closely and start bagging if needed. In C, bradycardia and hypotension, though hemodynamic complications are usually not the most prominent. Keep them on the monitor though, because they are at risk to develop ventricular dysrhythmias, and get an ECG. In D, you'll see pinpoint pupils and they have a depressed mental status. With that depressed mental status, they could lose their respiratory drive, so monitor B. This is where you would give the antidote, naloxone, which I'll get back to. Note that opioid overdose is associated with irreversible brain damage. Other complications include seizures. Check for head trauma. In E, bowel sounds are reduced due to paralytic ileus. The opioids itself could already cause hypothermia, but beware that these patients might have been lying on the floor for an unknown period of time. This could lead to even more severe hypothermia and rhabdomyolysis. This is why you check for head trauma and D. Their skin feels normal to cold. Rewarm your patient using blankets, a bear hugger, or warm infusion. Beware of transcellular shifts of potassium when you do so. Through our ABCDE assessment, we figured out that this is an opioid toxidrome. All vitals are downregulated, and the patient has pinpoint pupils. We can thus anticipate for possible complications, like respiratory depression and brain damage. We should therefore get the appropriate blood work, an arterial blood gas, liver and renal panel with electrolytes, CK, etc. Don't forget the tox screen. We've also already started the appropriate supportive treatment, providing respiratory support and rewarming the patient. Move on to risk assessment. Can the patient tell you what he took, when, etc.? For opiates, it's extremely important that you know if this patient is a chronic user, in other words, if he's opioid dependent. More on that later. Common opioids are morphine, oxycodone, and heroin. Note that in opioid overdose, there is frequently a co-ingestion with alcohol, benzodiazepines, or paracetamol. Next, go through the general steps of treatment as discussed in the introductory video. Note the contraindications for decontamination if the patient is comatose. There's an antidote for opiates called naloxone, which blocks the opiate receptors. Naloxone should only be given in respiratory depression, whilst on the monitor, and with extreme caution in chronic users as they could go into withdrawal, which results in a sympathomimetic toxidrome. Dilute 0.4 mg in 10 cc's of normal saline, so you get a 0.04 mg per milliliter solution. Give 1 milliliter or 1 cc every 2 minutes and titrate up until the patient starts breathing again. Note that the duration of action is about 1 hour, so your patient will need continuous infusion on a medium or critical care unit. And that is all for the opioid toxidrome. Please share this video if you liked it or give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next one.